Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Miami, Florida. I'm vlogging today because I am about to start a new contract on board a Royal Caribbean cruise ship. I work on a cruise ship, and it's going to start from today. And basically, today is crew sign-on day. So I am literally all packed up. I spent the one night here in Miami in this hotel. This is where I was put up. And I've just about repacked my suitcase here, so everything I've got in here is gonna, well, it's basically gonna last me 6 months. There's 6 months worth of clothes and toiletries and everything else I need in here. And I've got all my documents here, so my passport, my US C1D visa, my cruise seaman's book, and my, what else? Oh, my medical. And that's pretty much all you need to join a ship. So basically, I've got a Uber on the way. I'm gonna head down and check out the hotel, and then we're gonna basically head over to Port Everglades, and I'm actually going to show you the whole sign-on process. Like, I'm going to try and vlog as much as possible of me literally walking onto the ship and getting into my cabin. I want to give you guys a ship tour of the ship I'm working on. Oh, so I didn't even mention, I'm working on Royal Caribbean's Independence of the Seas. So yeah, with that being said, I'm gonna make my way down and I'll see you at the cruise port. Oh, there she is. Home sweet home. All right, all checked in. Just have to get all of our luggage on board. These are all the new crew members signing onto the ship. All right, so we're just going through the process of embarking onto the ship now.
Check it out. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to Fort Lauderdale Terminal 18. At this time, we'd like to advise that
all right, just got onto the ship. Now I need to find my cabin. These are my new crewmates. All right, and now I'm about to go into the crew cabin. This is what the crew corridors look like. These are the crew corridors. Ready? You're not on camera. It's just me.
In front of him, so do you know your
number?
I think we're
now
in the video.
4380. Yeah, I'm in cabin 4357. It's along here somewhere. Okay, here's my corridor. Shoppy corridor 4357. Let's see if my key works. Alright, so I just quickly threw everything in my cabin. And we're going up to the manager's office now. This is the crew elevators. Hi, shop manager.
Hello.
Hi, new workmates. Making friends already. This is the shop office. This is my manager. What's up, dude? All right, so now that I've gone into my cabin and checked in, I want to do a whole ship tour because I can get away with kind of being a guest today. Okay, so I'm just going to leave the manager's office now. So I want to show you how quickly it is to get into the guest area. So this is all crew areas, as you can tell. It's colors of the walls, the colors of the floors. And then as soon as I go out this door, we are on promenade. Look at that. Oh, look, Christmas trees here. So this is actually the best time for me to actually show you around the ship, because the guests don't actually come on board until 10:30, and it's only 10 o'clock now. So here's the promenade. This is the start. Here's the main Juicy Free shop. So here's one of the shops that I'll be working in. Everything on the ship is closed right now. So everything on the ship will open when we set sail at 5 o'clock. I will do a tour of the shops as well. But yeah, look. Sorrento is closed as well. Best pizza at sea. Yeah, I mean, the shops look so different compared to last time I worked here. These Coke machines weren't here. These weren't here last time I worked on here. Everything else looks the same for now. Here's the pub. All clean, all good. Casino, another shop. Another shop, amen. Yeah, the ship looks kind of weird when it's all empty. Vintages. Michael Kors. Jewelry shop. So yeah, expect to find me in any one of these. This all still looks the same. Cafe Promenade. Looks the same. Ah, okay. This is new. What is this? Sugar Beach. Oh, it's a sweet shop. Okay, this used to be the old cupcake store. Now it's a sweet shop. Yeah, even all the shop names are different. This used to be called Seasons, but this is not the collection. Next cruise is... Oh, this looks fancy in here. This is actually where I hope to work next. I'm working on that right now, but we'll see. Boom, the fastest internet at sea. Only at Royal Caribbean. I forgot what this bar's called. Guest services looks the same. Yo, it looks shiny. So the reason why I'm saying it's different is because earlier this year, there was a whole refurb of the ship and a whole bunch of new stuff has been installed. So I'm just trying to look out for all the new stuff now. All right, so I'm gonna make my way down to deck 4 now. Now I know there's definitely some new stuff down here. I just need to find it. And I'll show you Park West Art Gallery a bit later on as well. Okay, right off the bat, this is a brand new sports bar. Okay, this definitely wasn't here last time I was here, but I'm struggling to actually remember actually what was here now. My God, it looks great in here. Jesus, look at all these screens. Okay, if I was a guest on board, I would be totally in my element. Look at that, we got ESPN, we got the Premier League on here. This is fantastic. Look at these pool tables. I think they do food in here as well. I'll try and look for a menu a bit later on. Oh yes, look at this. My God. Okay, so this right now is definitely the best part of the refurb. But I'm really struggling to actually remember what was here. And here we go through the casino. I'm going to imagine the casino looks the same, more or less the same. Although I've heard now that the casinos are also non-smoking. So you used to be able to smoke in here. But saying that, I can still smell smoke. So I don't know, maybe it's certain Royal Caribbean ships you can't smoke in the casino. But it looks... Yeah, it looks shiny. Everything looks shinier. I will definitely say that. Okay, so just walking through the casino, I've come to the other side of deck 4, and we're now going into the Royal Theatre. Now, this used to be called Alhambra Theatre, but they've changed it to Royal Theatre now. I think it sounds better. Maybe all the... Oh, it's closed. Okay, I'm going to have to... I'm going to have to try and get in like another time. Okay, I've just snuck in. Now please, if you're ever a guest, don't just walk through the door like I just did. But this is the theatre. See the cleaning and everything in here. It looks bigger than what I remember. I don't know if they've actually made any changes to the theatre apart from the name. But yeah, I can't wait. I'm not sure if they've actually installed any new shows on this ship or not, but even if it's still the old shows, it's the same as last time. No, I'll definitely still enjoy watching it. Okay, so it's a little later on in the day now. It's almost 12 p.m. and all the guests are starting to come on board the ship. So now I'm going to take this opportunity to try and take you to all of the places that that were closed off before. So I want to take you now into the main dining room. Okay, this looks so different to when I last worked there. It looks, I'm trying to figure out what they've done there. I think there's like new chairs here. Yeah, all these new white chairs. It makes the dining room look a lot brighter. I actually really like it. And again, everything just looks new, and it's, everything smells new. I wish I could somehow bring the smell into the camera, but yeah, dining room looks great, especially with all the Christmas decorations. I can smell, I think I can smell bread. I can smell like freshly baked bread. All right, I'm gonna head up to Windjammer to see if it's open, because yeah, I'm hungry. I did have breakfast this morning when I left in the hotel. Well, I say breakfast, it was my leftover pizza from last night. Okay, so I'm back at the top of deck 11. Now this is the current prices of the drink packages.
They should just buy a small package.
No, it's gotta be, it's a large one.
If I buy the large one.
Obviously as a crew member, I don't need to buy a drinks package. What is going on here? What is going on? Look at this. Look at this. Look at this guy.
We love you, Bob Marley.
So we have to wash up, we have to wash our hands here.
No washing on food.
Can I wash your hands for you?
Yeah. No washing on food. Yeah. Everybody.
Alright, just wash my hands. That was the best thing I've ever seen. Now, that will make guests wash their hands. Oh, look at this. Welcome to Independence of the Seas. All right, let's see what we've got cooking today. Okay, Windjammer is really busy right now, but this station over here is pretty empty, the fast food section. So I think I'm gonna build my plate over here. We got burgers, pizzas, fries. Yeah, I'm gonna come here. I'll be right back. Okay, so I've just finished up eating all my food at Windjammer, and I've just made my way back out. Now this is Chops Grill, so this is the steakhouse. They usually have a menu out here, but they've taken them away. But there's a steakhouse in here, which I highly recommend. The petite filet mignon, that's my always go-to. And then over on this side, we have Giovanni's, which is the Italian restaurant on board. And if the menu is the same, again, there's no menu out here, but I remember the scallops in here were amazing. That makes me so happy. Okay, I'm gonna head back out to the pool. I think the weather's starting to warm up quite a lot now in Fort Lauderdale. Oh yeah, it's hot. Ooh, this is new. Fish and chips. Okay, hi. $9 fish and chips. Huh. I wonder if Americans actually like fish and chips. Okay, kids area, this is new. New slides. This looks great. Oh, cool. I wonder if grown-ups are allowed to do that. Okay, so new water park area for kids. Let's go up here. And this is what the kids pool looks like from the top. I like this thing up here. And right now I'm on like the highest point of the ship. I'm just up on this little area here. I'm not sure what it's called. But yeah, this is one of the
exactly as high as I can get unless I can figure out a way to get up there, for example. But yeah, this is what the pool area looks like. So the kids' pool was around there. This is the main adults' pool, and then there's another selection of pools just down here, where it's more of a relaxing solarium type area. All right, here we go. Maybe they'll switch it on a bit later. Okay, this is definitely new. Okay, this slide is definitely not here. And all of this is new. What is this? Look at these hammocks. You can just chill in here. Right, I'm gonna have to try and get in this. Check me out, I'm in the hammock. This is so cool. Okay. All of this is new. This is so cool. What's this sky? I need to go check this out. I have no idea what this is. Okay, this slide is awesome. I wonder if I'll ever get a chance to ride it. So you go up, you take the stairs, and then you just go through the tubes. And then you come out of here. Nobody's on it yet. And I've just made it over to the new basketball court. Yo, this looks good. I'm loving the floral. I think the climbing wall's new. It looks like it's in a new position. I apologize if you can't hear me because of the wind. I'm trying my best. But this looks... yeah, this looks good. Okay, so it looks like they've either got rid of or they've moved the mini golf to make room for basically this new slide and new trampoline thing that they've got up here. Trampoline VR, something like that. The guy tried to explain it to me before, but I need to see it to fully understand. But the new sports deck, I like it overall. Okay, so I was just walking along deck 11 still. And I think I found the new mini golf. Yeah, so they've moved the mini golf. Oh, wow, okay. I can see it already. It looks awesome. Okay, hold on, let me just make my way around to it. Okay, this looks so much fun. This looks so much better than what the old mini golf was. Yeah, this is cool. Okay, I've just come back inside. I'm still on the top deck, and the spa is actually through here now. So I want to try and go inside and have a look. Oh, this is cool. Hi. Can I just go in and have a look? Ooh, okay. So if you're the type of person that likes to come to the spa, check this out. Now I actually come and get my haircuts from in here. Obviously, of course, I get a crew discount. Okay, so that was the spa. And now if I just go down one deck, I can get into the gym. And I can show you what fitness facilities there are. Now here is the gym. Yeah, this looks good. Right, let me see. From what I can tell, the gym looks the same. I don't think they've made actually any changes here. But yeah, the gym and the spa are usually connected together. But again, best gym in the world. You know, you can look out the window. Hold on, let me go out here. You can run on the treadmill and look out the window to a new view every single day. So one day you might be looking out at Florida, the next you'll be looking out at sea, and then to wherever you're going to sail to next. And that right there is basically a general tour of a Royal Caribbean cruise ship. There's still so much more that I didn't even show you. Like, there's numbers of bars and lounges that I I haven't even got round to yet. But yeah, this is basically where I'm going to be working for the next 6 months. Okay, I'm actually back in my cabin now, but I just wanted to show you. Check out my new name badge. Now I will do a tour of what the crew cabin looks like, but I still haven't unpacked everything yet, so I might have to save that for another video. Okay, so here we go. All set, ready, back for my first day of what, well, not my first day, but my first day of this new contract. Name badge is looking good. And yeah, so I think I'm going to end today's vlog right here, because I know it's been a long one. So today I basically showed you signing onto the ship and gave you a quick ship tour. What I have planned now is I want to make more vlogs of showing you the crew areas. So I want to give you a proper tour of our crew cabin once I've fully unpacked everything and given this place a little tidy. Can't speak. And I want to show you, yeah, where we work, the crew areas, like the crew bar, maybe like our training room if I'm allowed to. And I want to show you a true experience of what working on a cruise ship is like over the course of a 6 month period. So with that being said, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.